And we have another one very similar to the topic that we were talking about. And is it, why would anyone want to be in a physical body when they can be a free spirit?
Ask a dead guy. Ask some guy that's running around haunting their fucking house, wanting, they're free. They're stupid, it's what they are. They don't get it. No, that's not entirely true. I got a little touchy about ignorance. Not to say that I'm the smartest guy, sharpest guy in the tool shed. It's not Guy Rich, it's tool. Oh, okay. Don't be a tool. Okay, got it. Anyway, back where was I? Some people want to play Earth life games, and so they want a physical body. They want to do that. The realm that they're in isn't working for them. Their beliefs are that they would prefer to be in a physical body, so that will motivate them to do something about getting into a physical body. But it has to do with what they believe and what they want, and what they want has to do with what they believe. What they want is going to make them feel or experience a certain way, and that's what they would like to feel and experience that. So that they want this because getting that is supposed to help them feel the way they want to feel. Kind of thing. So some people want to be in a physical world. Other people are quite happy in a non-physical realm. Now they might be in one where they walk around on the streets and through the forest, and they may or may not be able to fly or go through walls. But if they're happy there and they're not interested in coming into the physical world with a physical body, no problem. If they can't fly, for example, or go through walls, they don't have their superpowers in their non-physical world, they might feel limited. And they might not be getting enough in their non-physical realm to satisfy them. Their beliefs are that they'd get more joy or more fulfillment by getting into a physical body. So they would say yes to coming back into the physical world, being reincarnated. Or they're just fine there, they love it there, but somebody tells them that they need to learn more, develop more human emotion or more human character traits like courage or something. The ability to make wise decisions. And you could learn that in the physical world. So you should go back. If you think that's a good idea, you want to do that, and you believe you can learn that going into the physical world, okay. So you would once again have another compelling reason to come back into the physical world where you can't fly and be a free being. But you could be talked into doing something by friends, even in this life. You ever been talked into going someplace and you wish you hadn't gone, like a party or something, or out to dinner with the family or something? You get talked into it and you wish you hadn't have done it. That can happen. You can be over there talked into coming back here, and you wish you hadn't done it. So that's the thing.
And relating to that subject, why would people want to incarnate in this planet? Knowing how enslaved and bad it is over here, why would someone from out there want to come back or just incarnate for the very first time in here?
Like their very first time here?
Oh, both, like the very first time or come back again, even though they have an option to go back and they're just like, oh, I'll just go back. Why would someone want that?
Well, lots of reasons. One is the great reason that you feel a sense of duty or love or compassion for your fellow beings, and you want to help, you understand what's going on, and you want to help awaken people to a better life. Those people that are on the physical world planet while you're not, most of them are going to be reincarnating over and over again. And they're not going to learn a lot. They're going to think they might learn something, but they're not really learning a lot. You've kind of watched them over and over again. They're not getting smarter. And people on the physical realm and in the non-physical realm are doing whatever they can to keep these human beings in physical bodies ignorant and dumbed down, not understanding what's going on in the bigger picture. They become slaves, the human beings, free-range slaves on their little planet, unaware as can be, taken advantage of. So somebody with compassion or love for their fellow man would have compelling reasons to come back and help. Now, when you come back, you get a mind wipe. You don't get to come back with all your memory. That's part of the problem. That's what needs to be fixed. So you make a judgment call. Well, is it worth me going back with all these restrictions? But you make these agreements called soul contracts or soul contract agreements that give you all these restrictions on how to live your, how to be, and what kind of character traits and skills and intelligence and all this stuff. It's part of your agreement package. So you make these agreements, and part of that is a mind wipe, blank, amnesia, you don't remember. So then you come back here. If you're lucky, you'll wake up to what the hell, why you came back, and then you do what you can to help yourself get up to speed and wake up to what's going on, and then do what you can to help other people wake up. It's really, you just need to know. You just need to wake up and know. You don't really have to do anything about it. Because if your body gets killed, like in directed energy weapons or fake tsunamis, Fukushima, nuclear accidents where there weren't accidents, hurricanes that were directed with high energy microwave, HARP, and other things to, you know, cause great damage and death and destruction. Once you drop dead in any kind of way, you know, you can get out of here. And if you already know what the hell, you go, okay, I get it. And so when you drop dead, you're in another realm and you go, you know, do you want to go back again or not to help or not? And then you make another choice. So that's one kind of people that come here. Other people are absolutely clueless. They've been generation, generation, generation. They live a life. They drop dead. They go to between lives area for some. Sometimes they're addicted to this. They don't know any better. They want to come back and live a better life. They make these choices to come back. They don't remember much. They don't learn much in their life. You know, when you think about in like the old West, like Red Dead Redemption 2, you know, you look at all the people, they're so busy surviving that there's not a lot of time for meditation and spiritual development and intellectual or philosophical growth. So when they drop dead, maybe they had some big agenda to do something from their perspective important in their life. If they don't get it done between lives, they're going to, you know, there was that really important thing. I really wanted to get that done. So they're going to want to come back. They got a limited view and perspective, and their goals or objectives or purposes are smaller, more personal. So they're going to, you know, that kind of person, they'll keep coming back to get it right. And they could have people, guides on the other side that will encourage them to come back. Some nefarious types can pretend to be good people, beings on the other side, and talk you into doing a life review and coming back for another round. But they're not going to really enlighten you on this planet. They're going to keep you dumbed down and ignorant. They're not going to teach you about between lives, what really goes on here or there. And they want to keep recycling you back into more physical bodies.